Hello everyone, and welcome to my kitchen. My name is Jackie Valentine, and I'm an exhibits experience lead at the Fleet Science Center. Now I have a demonstration for you today that uses things that I've actually just found around my kitchen. Because at the Fleet we have this philosophy that science is everywhere. So you may think that maybe being stuck at home there's not really any science to experience, you can't come out to the Science Center and see all the cool things that we have there, but really, it's all around you. There's all kinds of stuff that science is a part of. So we're going to kind of see that today. Now, of course, since this is an example and a demonstration, it's not necessarily something that you should try at home because it does use fire. We have a candle here that will be the source of the fire, and we're actually going to use an orange, and you'll find out in a second why. You may think, oh, an orange, that's not very dangerous, that's totally fine. But of course, you're going to see something that maybe you didn't know about in a few moments. Of course, please don't try this at home. I have my setup here at the stove. The stove is made to have fire at it. It doesn't have any sort of fabrics or anything that can catch fire or get singed or anything like that. You don't want to accidentally burn the carpet or the couch. And I'm a trained professional, so that's my job, all right? Now, before we get into it, we're going to kind of wonder, what do you think is going to happen? How is the candle and the orange going to come into play with each other? What's the result going to be? You kind of want to think about that first. And then as we get closer and closer to the actual testing time, you may change your guesses. We call those a hypothesis. When you make a hypothesis, that's just basically a guess as to what's going to happen next. And then you do a test to find out if you were right or wrong. And if you're wrong, you do a new hypothesis, you do another test until you have the right answer, and you find out what the truth of your experiment really was. All right, so let's find out what happens. First, we have to peel the orange.
Now, while I'm peeling this orange, we're gonna look at the actual peel itself. You'll see there's a bunch of these little bumps, and those are actually a little bit of a hint as to how the experiment is going to work and what we'll see next. All right, looks like the orange is all finished. Let's try this out.
All right, now that our orange is peeled, we can light our candle next. Now this is where the magic happens. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take one of these orange peels, and I'm just going to actually squeeze it like this, and we'll see what happens. Let me turn this light up here off. Pretty cool, right? Now, the question is, what just happened? Why did the flame kind of spark and get bigger when I squeezed the orange peel? Do you guys have any guesses? Do you guys think you know maybe how it works, or do you have questions? Do you have these burning questions that you want to find out why does that happen? What's the secret? What's the magic behind this science?